Good morning, children. There are many organisms in our environment. They are living as well as non-living organisms. The living organisms are plants, animals, and microorganisms. Why we are saying plants as living organisms? Because they can grow, they can reproduce, they can respire, and they can show irritability. That means response to the stimuli. There are millions of plants around us. Children, do you all like plants? Yes, we all like plants. They are useful in many ways. They give us food, medicines, give us spices, fibers, and some of them are ornamental purpose also. First, we can see the food plants. Plants which give us food are called food plants. We cultivate many crops like paddy, millet, ragi, maize, wheat, coconut, and vegetables for food. Where we are getting these vegetables? These vegetables are a part of a plant, either a leaf or a stem or an unripe fruit. For example, carrot, radish, their roots are used as food. Onion, potato, sugarcane, we are using their stem as food. Leafy foods, for example, spinach, mint, cabbage. And some of the plant seeds are used as food. They are pulses and grains. For example, green gram, red gram, Bengal gram, etc. Next, we are going to see medicinal plants. Some of the plants, they are used to cure many diseases. They are called medicinal plants. Because of their medicinal properties, they are known as herbal plants. Nowadays, plant-based medicines are preferred throughout the world. From ancient days, plants are used to cure several diseases in our country. These herbal plants are grown naturally in forests, mountains, and hills, and some of them are found in roadsides also. Now we can see some of the medicinal plants. For example, tulasi. Tulasi plant, it is used to cure cold, cough, fever. Eucalyptus, it is used to cure cold. Ginger, for throat pain as well as for curing cough and cold also, and easy to digest. Gooseberry, it cures mouth ulcer and regulates our body temperature. Then turmeric, manjal, it is used as a germicide and is used to prepare some antiseptic medicines also. Next, cosmetics. We all love beautiful flowers such as rose, lily, jasmine. And these flowers, they play a key role in preparation of cosmetics like bathing soap, talcum powder, deodorant, and perfumes. Next, spices. While we prepare a food, we can get a good smell and pleasant odor. What is the reason for this? It is because of the spices that we add to it. Why we are adding spices to the food? Because the food gets good smell and color, and the spices are used to increase the amount of food we eaten and the digestion rate. Many parts of the plants such as leaves, stems and flowers are used as spices. Some of the spices are fenugreek, fennel, mustard, ginger, cinnamon, pepper, cardamom, mint, clove. Next, fiber plants. Some of the plants, they are giving fibers. What is a fiber? It is a long, thin, strong strand obtained from plants. The dress, the jute, the gunny bags, they are the products of the plants. And jute fiber is obtained from the plant jute. jute is used to make pillow, bed, mat, mattresses. And some of the fibers are used to weave cloths, make nets and handicrafts. And the fibers are classified based on the parts of the plants from which they are obtained. They are stem fibers, external fibers and leaf fibers. What are stem fibers? The plantain fiber and jute are obtained from the stem of the plant. Leaf fibers are obtained from the leaves of aloe vera, pineapple. And the external fibers are obtained from the outer region of the seed. For example, cotton, coconut, silk cotton, this and all. Next slide ID, plants in construction. Some of the plants give us wood. What is the use of wood? It is used in building constructions and making furniture. There are two types of wood, heartwood and sapwood. The dark inner region of the stem is called heartwood and the outer region is called sapwood. Sapwood helps to conduct water in plants, but the heartwood gives strength and rigidity to the plant. It is not infected by fungus and it is stronger than sapwood. Next, ornamental plants. Some of the plants like Araucaria, Agathis, Gingko biloba, and these plants we can see everywhere. That is, in garden we can see some of the plants, and some of the plants are grown in house for ornamental purpose. Now students, we are going to wind up the class. Now you all understand the value of plants. And they are a gift of nature. Plants fulfill the basic needs such as food, clothing and shelter. And forests are necessary for getting rainfall. Trees purify the air. So all of you understand about the value of plants. Do not harm the plants and do not destroy the plants. If you can plant the trees or creating gardens in your background or school campus, do it. Thank you.